something now. Whoa, that was a good jump. You can see it's now nightfall in the Red Sea, and while I'm here, I'm hoping to get my certificate for advanced diving, and that involves me doing dives of all different kinds. One of them is a night dive. I tell you what, I am really, really looking forward to this.
It was so different to diving during the day. Beyond our camera lights, the water was pitch black, and I have no idea what was out there. These are lionfish, and they come out at night to hunt. They were attracted by our camera lights. Other creatures like this hermit crab were attracted too, and the lionfish were soon on the chase. Smaller prey didn't stand a chance. Even when I found a moray eel, the lionfish couldn't stay away. Yasser led me deeper, exploring between the corals. Too soon, it was time to return to the surface.
Oh, yes! Now that was fantastic! Ah, that is, I tell you what, that is a great way to spend the evening.
Meg, you're the best dog in the world. Now, I'd done very little riding before I joined Blue Peter, but that soon changed, and I've been in and out of the saddle ever since. Known as rugby on horseback, polo takes stamina, skill and courage.
And it's Matt Baker up in front of goal now for the Blue Peter team.
Back at Matt! Back! Go on.
The pace of the game was unbelievable, and I was struggling to make contact with the ball.
Short line, yeah?
Things weren't looking good, until suddenly we were given a penalty, and the team decided I should be the one to take it.
So, Baker, spot penalty hit. Can he get hold of this one on that grey pony? Matt Baker looks like a better connection to me, and it's through the middle.
By chukka three, I was growing in confidence, but we still needed to score, and fast.
Matt Baker's there in front of goal. It's Matt up in front of goal. He scored. Another one there for Matt Baker.
Very, very, very exhilarating.
We'd lost, but I was more than pleased with my effort.
Yes! Rock on, TV boy!
Thanks, matey. My challenge was to ride at speed with one hand on the reins and the other holding a sword.
Just to practice, keep the left leg on.
To slice a watermelon in two.
Leg, lovely. Now leg on!
Fine!
That's it.
Yes! Hey! That was a beauty!
Well done there, Matt.
Oh, clean through, swiped it right in half. That was lovely, that was.
I've got him. Yeah, let's fly. We've got takeoff.
Woohoo!
How was that?
This was great. I did not believe that you would manage it.
They're just a great, great horse.
Come on, Matt.
Got it.
That's it. It's lovely.
Good boy.
Just sit together. Hold on to that, David.
Good
Come
boy.
On, Matt.
Good
Help
boy.
David out. Keep pushing with him, lovely.
Good
Keep coming,
boy.
Matt. Come on, push, Matt.
Got it. Got son.
Hold
got
David.
It.
Hold him, David. Hold him, David.
Got it.
Hold
got
him,
on.
David. Come on. Come on, Matt.
Got
Hold
son.
On, David. Pull up,
got
David.
On, lad.
Come on,
got
take a pull.
On. There's a good boy.
Take a pull, David. Go on,
Go
Matt,
on.
Push.
Go
harder,
on,
harder.
Son. Come on. Yes. Good lad.
Come on,
Good
David,
boy.
Take a pull.
Come on. Come on.
Go on,
yeah.
Matt, get there. Take a
Go
pull,
on,
David. That's
son.
It. Together, together, together,
We're
together.
Get him. Come
together.
On.
Take a pull.
There's a good boy. There's a good boy.
That's it. Well done, Matt.
Good lad.
Gently ease them up gradually
and
now.
Whoa. Yes!
I had done it. Top
yes!
speed on a thoroughbred racehorse.
Just fantastic.
Last summer, I was delighted to discover that Meg was expecting her first litter of puppies, and I couldn't wait to share the news with Blue Peter viewers.
The ultrasound is going to be produced by me putting the probe on Meg's
yeah.
tummy.
Okay.
You know what this is like, Meg? I've been
Good
through
girl.
It.
Thanks, Liz. That's yes. very kind of you.
If I just put it on her tummy.
No, no, steady.
There you go.
Oh, there's a little puppy in
is
a
that
sack
one there. Is
there.
It?
And then if I move further over, we can see more puppies.
Oh, Meg, look.
Little head
wow.
here and a body and the heart beating.
So that's one puppy then, is it?
That's one puppy there, and I think I could count about sort of four or five.
Four or five, there we are.
Now, Meg's pregnancy is expected to last 63 days. The pups can come a bit early, or they could come a bit late, but we are now on day 62, aren't we? So they could come at any moment. In here is a special bed that my dad has made for Meg. It's called a whelping box, and it's designed so that Meg can jump in and out, go and do whatever she wants, go at the loo and what have you, and all of the pups will be left in here. They'll be safe and Meg will know exactly where they are. But here comes the clever bit. We've rigged the box with lots of little cameras. There's one down here, there's one here, and there's one all the way over there.
A long wait through the night lay ahead. And as it was Meg's due date, I wanted to stay with her just in case anything happened.
Well, it's now 6 o'clock in the morning. I honestly thought that we'd have some puppies by now. There's Meg, look, looking quite relaxed, not too fussed. Bit hot, started panting quite a lot in the last hour, haven't you?
A whole morning of panting went by, and in the early afternoon, Meg started to become restless.
All right. Oops.
Come on, Meg. Have a good lick. Look. There you go. I'm amazed. There's a good little pup. Oh, hello. That was your first little squeak. Even at this early stage, you can see what the markings are going to be. Want a bit of a hand drying it there then, Meg? It's really important that you dry them off quite quickly because they're used to being so lovely and warm tucked inside of Meg. And then out here's a bit chilly for them, especially if they're wet. I'm just gonna give them a little rub-a-dub-dub in the towel. It's 3 o'clock, exactly an hour after the first one was born. Again, it's backwards. All right. There's number two, and that's another big one. When they're born in a membrane or a bag, and it's really important to clear the nose and the mouth straight away so they can start breathing. Because they get all of their oxygen through an umbilical cord, which is attached to Meg, and as soon as that's broken, they have to then start breathing for themselves.
Meg was doing a great job, but to help her out, I showed the puppies where they could get their first drink of milk.
Now, there's a little wax seal on here, and I'm just going to break it. There you go, look. And then, hopefully, she'll get a little taste. And that's it. They've started fending for themselves now. And this time is really important because the puppies are born blind and deaf, and the only sense that they have is their sense of smell. So they're really working out what Meg smells like, and likewise, she's working out what they smell like. Because they're after the colostrum, which is the first milk that's going to come from Meg's milk bag, which is going to help protect them and make them good, strong pups. You love them, don't you, Meg? She looks really proud of herself. Head first, perfect. Well, there's number three. With one white leg, looks like at the front. Again, very good size. And thankfully, that one came out head first.
Meg's instincts had well and truly taken over, and we all knew that Dad Jed would be very proud of his newborns. With a champion sheepdog for a dad, there's a good chance that one of the puppies will be following in his paw prints.
We're now on to number four. There we are. Jump in there. You mind out the way, little one. That is absolutely perfectly marked, this one. It's either red or brown, this one. Definitely. If you're a boy, we'll call you Rusty. If you're a girl, we'll call you Ruby. How about that? I'm just going to put them all into this little basket. There we are. You'll all be together in a second. Okay. I know you were just having a lovely drink. But don't worry. Okay. I'll just cover them over with this. So I think it's dark. I just give them a little rub.
It had been an exhausting 24 hours, but at 7:57, Meg had her fifth and final puppy.
Well, number five is now tucking in for some milk. And number five is a little boy. So we now have two boys and three girls, I think. That's it, they've started fending for themselves now. And just to think, a few hours ago, she had no idea what was gonna hit her. And here she is, a mum of five beautifully strong, healthy puppies. A clever girl. And I'll tell you what, nature is an awful wonderful thing.
That is a very, very good likeness of Meg. You've got the ears there, absolutely perfect.
That's pretty good. It's from Jenny Rockcliffe from Selby in North Yorkshire. And as I said, she has sent us a poem as well. I'm going to read it to you now. Here we go. It says, Meg, you're a star. You're the best by far. Your pups are so cute and so are you. Meg, you're the top dog. Cheeky and fun, Meg, you're a star. You're the best by far.
Oh,
isn't that nice?
Oh,
that
is she lovely. Is. You're absolutely right with that one.
Thanks, Jenny. Brilliant.
Oh, that's
here.
There
cute.
We are. What about that? I'm very pleased
there
with that.
She
there
is.
She
is.
She doesn't look that impressed
Meg,
at the moment.
You don't look very interested.
Is it time to rinse off this? It helps dry them a bit.
It does help dry them a lot, actually, when you to get the loose water off, but obviously it gets everything wet, and the mum won't always appreciate that, so...
yeah.
Sorry, Connie,
is
just
she
fluttered
enjoying it.
Whoops, sorry.
You did that on purpose.
Very gently.
Children will be children, won't they?
Look, the water actually looks... She's quite enjoying this whole experience.
Oh, man. Peter, will you do me afterwards?
Liz!
Well, really.
I've got one.
You want to tidy, you want to get rid of the dead hair out of their bodies and also the...
On that note, before we get on washing the rest of the crew, here is some more... Loads and loads of you have emailed and written in to say how much you're going to miss Meg. So thanks ever so much for all of those lovely cards and messages. But don't worry, of course I promise I will always, always look after her. And I hope to bring her back to visit too. But that is it for my look back over my animal magical moments. Don't forget that next week you can see all of my biggest song and dance challenges. Until then, goodbye.